بداية حابين نشكركم على حضوركم هذه الورشة اليوم. This workshop إن شاء الله it will be about email, how to write professional email actually. Just I will give you at the beginning some introduction about the trainer. The trainer name today Dr. Mohammed Shafi' al-Din. He is a lecturer in University of Technology and Applied Science in Business Department. He is actually conducting many workshops in India, Oman, and UK. He published many research papers and conducting symposium also and workshops. So just at the beginning, I would like to inform you that at the end, there will be a feedback form will be posted in the chat. So please fill up that form, write your email in Arabic, and make sure that your email also will be correct. So at the later on, we'll send to you the certificate, e-certificate. It will be electronic certificate. Also, if you have any question, you can post it in the chat. So also at the end, we will allow you, or we will, Dr. Mohammed Shafi' al-Din will reply to your question. بالإضافة إلى بس I will speak in Arabic now. بالإضافة إلى طبعا جميع هذه الورش اللي قدمت خلال الملتقى جميعها موجودة في حساب الكلية على أو قناة الكلية على اليوتيوب. اللي حاب يطلع عليهن لاحقا أو حاب مرة ثانية يراجع هذه يرجع لهذه الوركشوبس اللي قدمت خلال الملتقى الأسبوع الماضي وهذا الأسبوع كلها موجودة على قناة الكلية على اليوتيوب. نفس الشيء الجدول الخاص بالملتقى موجود على موقع الكلية اللي هو www.nct.edu.om. دكتور محمد شفيع الدين, the mic is yours now. You can start.
Thank you very much, Ms. Zubaina Al-Riyami. I'm thankful to management and also the college, our HOD, to give me an opportunity to take it. Let us go very simply. And also I request the participants, if they feel incommunicated any time, they can just message or inform me. So today's our topic is etiquettes of professional electronic mail. Generally, we call email, electronic mail. When we discuss about this one, then there are many doubts comes to us. Is there any etiquette for email also? If it is there, then how it is? What is the necessity? So whenever you talk about the mail, generally my friends, whenever we are thinking about the mail, first question will come when this workshop has started and the topic is introduced. Then you all feel that why you need email etiquette? What is new to know? Emails are we are using. It has become one of the part in our daily activities. And also in this pandemic situation, this email are playing very important role in day-to-day communication. Then what is new? What we are going to discuss in this workshop? The question comes as that, what we are going to discuss a new thing? What this lecturer is going to tell us about a new thing about the email etiquette. Let us have what we are going to discuss. What we are going to discuss as. First of all, my friends, our email should have these things very, very carefully. Our email must be appropriate. If our mail is not appropriate, then the reader will not take care at all. And sometimes the language of English is a very difficult task to it. Although it is having only 26 letters, a small change of spelling may change its whole meaning. So we have to see the proper spelling and grammar. Grammar is a glamour to the language. So our email must be clear. It must be planned. It is in the form of professional. It must be in the form of professional. And before pressing the button of send, it must be proofread. We have to read once again. We have to read once again to it. and it should contains the subject line. The subject line is very, very important for us. We have to keep that subject line. We have to keep what subject we have to give. You have to give up. So what we can say that we have to see the subject line. The subject line is very, very important. And also respectful and polite. It should not be in the form of a command. We are not going to command by what we can say that we are not going to command by the giving of this whatever the male is it, we are not going to command him. We are going to tell what is it, what is it. So that's why what we can say that it requires some patience to what we can call, it will require the patience at the same time it required very carefulness. So that's why it will be what we can say that we should have all these elements to be present, all these elements to be present. Then only we can easily give our mail in the proper order. Now, actually, my friend, our email behavior can sabotage our professional reputation. The people will be able to justify because they have not seen us. They did not discuss with us. They are seeing only our mails. Our mail behavior is very, very, very important. If our email behavior is not in a good way, then our professional reputation goes down. So we have to keep very, very carefully. And here, what we are going to discuss in this workshop, let us relax. I'm not a presenter, I am one among you. I am sharing few of the things which I collected and few of the things which I experienced in my 32 years of teaching. So that's I'm sharing with you. If you have anything, you are welcome. You all people are well versed and you know everything very nicely. So we are sharing the knowledge. No one is a teacher, no one is a student, no one is a presenter, no one is a listener. We are sharing our knowledge to each other. So now, in between, I want to interrupt you. Are you able to follow my English? Any one of you can answer, please. Is it my English is enough to be followed? Any one of you? Yes, Reem. Reem Al-Shukaili.
Yes, Doctor, it is clear, but they're asking about the PPT file. Are you going to share something in the screen?
Yes, file I've not shared, I think. Sorry, madam. Sorry.
Yeah, this is what they are asking.
Okay. Now I shared. Are you able to listen, see my file?
Still.
Yes. Sharing okay. Is there?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Yes.
I was thinking that is already shared. Sorry, friends.
Okay. بس بالنسبة للي يسألوا عن التسجيل هو ما في تسجيل حاليا في فيدباك تقييم للورشة راح أرسلكم الرابط at the end يعني قبل لا تنتهي المحاضرة راح أرسلكم رابط في الشات ادخلوا على الرابط وعبوا هذا الفيدباك وبناء عليه طبعا راح يتم إرسال الشهادات بس تأكدوا إنه الإيميل يكون صحيح لأنه اللي إيميله ما صحيح إحنا كيف بنوصل له الشهادة لأنها راح تكون إلكترونيك سيرتيفيكيت أوكي Okay, Dr. Lucas, complete now.
Yeah,
I think still your PPT is not coming.
It's coming. I shared. Can you check? Is it shared? See? Is it shared?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So, my friends, sorry. These are the points which I was trying to explain to you. I'm extremely sorry the PPT was not shared. So now, we are going from the fundamental onwards. Let us see what we are going to discuss in this workshop. Let us have relax. Very relaxfully, let us discuss what we are going to discuss here. The first thing is that what is a professional email? Generally, there are different types of email. Inshallah, in the next slide, we'll be going to it. A professional email address is one that has your business name in it. For example, college.munairi@nct.edu.om. This, by seeing this professional mail, this mail, you will see that, oh, this person is from NCT. He has given a mail which is related to the Nizwa College of Technology. So it is a professional mail, actually. When we go to the classification of mails, emails are three types of emails: informal, semi-formal, formal. We can classify the emails into three types: informal, semi-formal, formal. When we talk about the informal, friends, relatives, family members, you can write anything. You can use the smileys, you can use anything, because it is an informal one. Semi-formal, neither they are informal nor they are formal. They are the teammates, are your classmates, are your colleagues. Some relaxations are there in the semi-formal. When you go for formal, they are purely professional communication. Here we have to take more and more care. Sometimes what happened, we use many things. Some dot, 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 or smileys, some question marks. No, it is a professional communication. Be professional. So let us go deeply to this one. The way which you are communicate, it reflects that which type of employee you are. Not only which type of employee you are, it will reflect your work ethic. What work ethics you have. It will reflect your professionalism, and it will reflect your attention to give the details. See, how many components are linked with your mail? The first thing is, your mail itself reflect to assess you which type of employee you are. And also it gives us what type of work ethics you have. What is your professionalism? And how much you are attentive to give the details. So these things very easily can be assessed by a person who is getting your mail. Email etiquette helps to streamline communication and make the information you are sending clear and concise. The message which you are sending by the mail, it must be very clear. And don't give big messages. Very point to point, concise, very concise. Because by seeing the mail, lengthy mails, people think that I will read tomorrow, but the tomorrow won't come. Generally, tomorrow will not come. Every day we think tomorrow. Today is tomorrow, tomorrow is tomorrow, tomorrow is tomorrow. So that's why the people, once the mail is postponed and he is busy person, he may be receiving 20, 30, 40, 50 mails per day. So he may not be able to concentrate. So see that your mail should be clear and concise. And also, people feel better about their jobs when they feel respected. When any employee is respected, then he feels that, oh, I am in a good position. My friends, many people think that, many employees feel that my salary is good. Salary is nothing. Your respect is more important. How you are respected by the employer, how you are treated by the employer, that is a good thing. It makes a good relationship with the customers. Employee should feel that this is my company. The minus should come when he get proper respect, when he get proper care, when his problems are attended. So that's why what we can say that his every nature depends upon his respect. If he is respectful, then he will work hard. Then he will be thinking that how better I can do for my organization. All your professional email communications, need to make an impression that you are someone that will be easy and a pleasure to work with you. This type of opinion should be created into the people whom you are sending. Then you will be a credible professional. You have a credibility. With email, you only have one chance to make the first impression. Your first impression is the best impression. So when I'm giving you first mail to you, anyone, you are creating your first impression, trust, confidence. So this, and whenever you talk about some reasons, I'm not going to talk, because if you go to the Google, you see that 14 rules of email etiquette, 24 rules of email etiquette, many rules are there. Rules maybe, but what we follow, what we have to do. So I made many rules into very small consign, because I was telling you to be consign in your mail. So I too thought that I must be consign in my presentation. So I have taken three reasons for email etiquette. Only three reasons. The first one is try to avoid confusion. First, you should know what mail you are going to give. If you don't know, then it is a big mess to the person who is receiving the mail. My friend, in the world, Allah Ta'ala has created lock and key. No one will prepare only lock. They prepare the lock and key. Lock is a problem, key is a solution. So for every problem, there is a solution. Solution is there. But the main problem is we don't understand what is the problem. When we don't know the problem, then how we find the solution? So that's why it is better that what mail we have to give. First, we decide. If possible, write the points on paper. These are the points to be covered in my mail. So avoid confusion. Don't go for fanciness. Nowadays, many social media has come into fanciness. They don't talk. They give a smiley. It doesn't mean that everyone will understand the smiley. So it is better to be the words which you are using, better to be understood. Do not use high English to show your English. Actually, communication means to say that what you want to tell the other person. The receiver should understand what sender wants to say. Sometimes what happens, they give a big English words. Once again, he has to go for dictionary. Sometimes people will feel that, Liu Kali Wali, what is this? So that's why poorly worded emails can lead to misinterpretation or mistake. People take in a wrong way if your words are too poorly given, because there is no meaning at all. You see, there is one example. I happened to see your workshop and felt happy with the content. Here, what is telling that I happened to see means he's not interested and he's not received any mail or he's not received any invitation. Happened to see. Only this happened killed his opinion. He felt happy that is not, he is uninvited guest. He has happened, accidentally he has seen my presentation workshop. So whenever you are using the words must have the clarity. And it should give a very clear information. Second, efficiency. Really, it is very difficult for us to define efficiency. Some people say that doing effectively. What is effective? So whenever go for the efficiency, emails that get to the point are much more effective than long emails. The email which you give point, if your email is having long things to cover, write in the points or break into paragraph. And first paragraph should not have any link with second paragraph. Every paragraph will have its own content. So that is very effective. And professionalism, when you are writing your email, you have to use the language which will convey a professional image. How you are giving, what you want to say, in a way that your professionalism must reflect in your email. Now I'll go for some tips. Means some of the small tips to be. Whenever you are talking about email, every organization will have its email policy. So check your organization's email policy. Many organizations have rules about types of messages. What messages we have to send. Sometimes some organization will monitor your screens, what you are doing. Make sure your email include very courteous greetings and closing. Good morning. Have a good day. Last, with regards. Finish. No demanding and no terms and no nothing will be. Address your contact with the proper appropriate level. And see that his name should be spelled rightly. People get very angry if you write his spelling in wrong way. So try to write his spelling. Check his name or anything from any website from the company. Spell correctly his name. Spell check emails. You can keep in email only spell check option in the Google. When you type wrong spelling, then it will show you. It will correct you. And read your email out loud. When you are reading loudly, then what happened? Your mind will be thinking. Means loudly reading is one of the habit that it will develop the concentration. This is the reason, my friend. Teachers in small classes, they said that read loudly. When he's reading loudly, he will not divert his concentration here and there. He will be thinking, the mind will be thinking. So read loudly once you are email. Be sure you are including all the details what you want to write. And refrain from using the reply to all feature. This is the biggest task. Whenever in my profession also I have seen that if someone give, your head of the department gives one mail to you to do this one, then the people, what they do, they want to say that we received the mail. They reply to all. Thank you, madam. We received. Thank you, sir. We received. This mail goes to all. Actually, this is not necessary. You want to answer only the person who has given mail to you. Sometimes the CEO or manager gives one mail by asking your opinion on some matter. Give to him. Don't answer to all. All people may be not interested. And sometimes what happens, it will mislead also. If you give your opinion to all, someone wants to give some opinion which is not like you. Then he thinks that, oh, he has given like this, so I will avoid my opinion. So management is unable to get the good opinion. So that is the reason that try to give reply to only the specific person who has sender, you to reply to it. Type in complete sentence. In English, the sentences are plays very important role. If you are unable to complete your sentence, the meaning will be incomplete. Always acknowledge email from those you know in timely manner. When a person gives a mail to you, immediately receive your mail. Thank you very much. Your mail should not contain that I received your mail on so and so date. Sorry, I am giving late reply. No, sorry, nothing. Just give him, receive your mail. Reply may be given later. No problem. And be sure the subject. Some people don't want to read the mail. If you write a subject, the subject is related to him, then he will go definitely to it. So be sure of keeping the subject. Sometimes what happened, people will keep the subject Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. It is not a subject, it is a salutation. It should go down. So, specially you write a subject which creates the interest in a person to read or not. Keep your emails very brief, I was continuously telling. Very brief and to the point. What you want to say, tell. Always end your emails, thank you, sincerely, best regards. Or with warm regards. Anything. Avoid unnecessarily large file size. Don't send him big, big files. He may be having the space or not. Digital photos. Learn how to resize your digital photographs. Just resize your it. Online, you can go and resize and send if you want to send. And don't type in capital. My friend, this is one of the important things. Don't type anything totally capital. For example, you see, are you able to see my word? Hello? Hello? Are you able to see my word?
Yes, doctor, it is clear.
Very good. Thank you. You see, I wrote here, good morning, in all capital letter. Of course, I've forgotten, I have not seen my key, cap ons or what. But in email, it gives one reflection that you are not happy with that person to whom you are giving the mail. You are angry. See, it is giving one indication. It is giving one indication. Just I use one example in our house. Sorry, not particular. Your mother or your wife in your house making a big sounds in kitchen. Throwing this one, that tap, 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 tap sounds are coming. This means that she is not happy, she is angry. Something has happened. This is one type. Children, your son is sitting there. You went to house, he did not greet you, he did not see you. Simply sitting by facing his people. This means that he is not happy with you. These all are indications, silence indications. They are giving us indication that this is happening or this is taking off. So, don't type capital letters. It is nothing but you are shouting. MashaAllah, the culture of Omani is very nice. The people, sometimes if I say to my student, what? Then immediately they ask me, teacher, why you are shouting? So, it is a calm, very good. It is good for health, good for everything, good for relations. So, when you type capitals, this is one of the rudest thing you are doing. And you want to know that you are giving a mail, but you don't want to know the person who is you are sending to mail. Then you can see blind carbon copy. You can see in the mail, BCC. After the CC, carbon copy, there is downside in emails. You have blind carbon copy, BCC. You can keep that BCC to a person who wants to know, but you don't want to keep this one to the person whom you are sending. Don't write anything you wouldn't say in public. In public, what language you cannot speak, don't speak in your mail. Be professional. And stay away from the abbreviations. Sometimes you think that they will be knowing. They will be knowing. You think that they know it. Abbreviation. I will write some abbreviations. Abbreviations. For example, if you use this abbreviation, you may say that PM. You are writing the PM. You are thinking that PM means the people knows. But most of the people thinks that PM means Prime Minister also. PM means Post Meridian also. And we are using this abbreviations many times. Abbreviations are not at all same in whole the world. Sometimes it may create confusion also. Avoid the abbreviations. P, yeah, you write. Avoid it. You may be thinking that one. And another thing, my friends, many times we write 12 p.m. In the clock time, there is a no 12 p.m., my friends. Just I want to clarify as a teacher, it is a 12 noon. It is a 12 noon. Okay, I am not going for that clarification of anything. And another one, because I am talking about the etiquette, let us start. BCC is very important one. Why we say BCC, blind carbon copy? You want someone to know what you are communicating with him, but you don't want the person who is you are communicating should know that this is going to other person. And don't write the public things, anything, abbreviations. Don't use the abbreviations. Avoid using of abbreviations. And if you want to send a big attachment, just give a mail to him that I want to send a large file. Can I send? Because nowadays people are using the files for sending virus, computer virus. Really, my friend, nowadays in computer science, in information technology, if you are expert in information technology, you may be getting 1,000 or 2,000 riyals per month salary. But if you are expert in hacking, people are paying more and more. Every organization is appointing one hacking person, ethical hacking. He's not hacking other sites. He is seeing that his site should not be hacked by someone. So attachments are very, very important. Sometimes you will send one PDF file. He may be seeing from mobile, his mail. His mobile may be not having the PDF opener. Then he will face a problem. So ask him, I want to send a big file. And which format shall I tell you? Send you. Think before you forward. Sometimes we get angry on some person, we will give a mail. No problem. Write the mail. Think, is it the correct mail? Once send button is pressed, then nothing in our hand. Everything is gone. And also, don't send any confidential or secret information through email. My friend, once you open your internet, you are not, what we can say that, private. Your life and your everything become public. I don't know how far it is correct. Sometimes say that a big companies, people, professional people, they use one laptop which do not have internet connection. They will do their office works, everything there. They will take into a flash and they will use the flash into the laptop. After that, they will throw that flash. This might finish. They will not keep the flash which used in internet once again to the laptop. See, this much care they will take. Nothing is personal here. Everything is public. I hope you are having the Facebook and many social media. Sometimes you will get a communication. Your friend is nearby you. Means he is telling, the Facebook is locating that your friend came to Nizwa. He is nearby you. He is giving. When you call your friend and say that, where are you, Nizwa? He will be wonder, huh? How you know? So this much the internet is became a public. That's why don't send any confidential or secret messages. And avoid sending professional mail in odd hours. When you get up night 1 o'clock to 12 o'clock, you think that, oh, I have to send them. Please avoid to show that you are working. Some people is there, they want to show that they are working. To show you are working, don't disturb others' private time. Most probably use office hours. If it is necessary, then first sentence of that, sorry to take your personal time. You don't have his right to take his personal time. This is the first line. The first line you have to write that, sorry to take your personal time. Second line, you have to explain the importance of the mail. Last line is a request. These three should be when you are giving the mail in odd hours. Why? Why you are giving the mail in that order verse? What is the necessity? You have to explain him. So don't try to disturb their personal hours, personal timings. You are paid for the time which you are using them. So whenever you talk about these things, greeting, purpose, action, message, signature, these are the five things are there which you can keep into the mail. Whenever you are writing the professional emails, this is, if you practice, if you start 2, 3, 4, 5 emails, inshallah, it will be very easy for you. Writing emails in the workplace, it requires a specific set of skills. You have to learn from your people. Every office culture is having a different set of culture of email. Every organization have its own pattern of sending. And in this one, primarily, you will have request and reply email. That is the one type of email. You will request them, please do this one, this one, or you will reply them. And second type is you will confirm the email. You have received the email or you have some turn. So in workplace, you have only these two. Either you request something to others or you reply. Or you will confirm the mail is received. In the request and reply emails, most of this one, you request the people to do such things or to attend the meeting or to comment on the policies which is made or give some questions, whatever the questions are there, or talk about the projects, this is. And wherever request and reply, you see here, one message, dear staff, human resource is considering implementing a casual dress policy in the workplace. Please provide feedback on the questions. And he has given some 4 questions. These are the questions which they require the answer. What can be considered for the casual dress? These 4 questions. Your input would be greatly appreciated. Your opinions can be discussed at the manager's meeting, October 1, 2020, 1 p.m. Please respond to the above question September 29. You see, he has given that deadline. Because at the same time in the mail, how professionally he mentioned that he has to discuss in the meeting of October 1. So he is asking 1 or 2 days before to him. Feel free to email at so and so. Thanks. Now here, this is one professional mail. Can anyone tell me there is one small mistake in this professional mail, which I was going on talking from long time? Can you identify me which one is a small mistake is there? Small, very small. Any one of you, my friends? Hello? Hello? No one will speak? Okay. Have you seen this thanks? See, after the thanks, there is one symbol, exclamation. Means he is giving exclamation for thanks. It should not be used in this one. I mentioned here whether you will be noticing and questioning me. Good. No issues. Confirmation email. How we have to confirm our emails? This kind of email, it creates a permanent record, written record or conversation record, because I received your mail, I discussed it with you in the project. These are the confirmations, some of the confirmations you are giving to you. These are the recorded things for both of you, the sender and receiver. If sometime back, afterwards you say that, no, you have not given opinion, then you can say, see, check the mail on that day. I replied to your mail by giving confirmation. So it is evidence. It is an evidence also, which can be proven legally. So these are the few things, confirmation mail. Now, once again, I come to the just to back point, how we are going to be subject line, how we write the subject line. The subject line must be very, very specific. It should not be vague. Vague means not clear. Sometimes, budget, they write the subject budget. What is a budget? They think that, oh, they want to produce a budget, leave it, we will study. If the budget, you will write specific, budget revision request, then you will understand, they are revisioning the budget. So I have to read, if I need any budget, I have to give mail. So whenever you are giving a subject, the subject should have a specific thing that the person who is receiving the mail should understand. What is the mail? Whether the mail is important to him or not. If the mail is not important, if the mail is not related to him, then he will not show interest. If he confused with your subject, then he thinks that this is not for me, then also goes. And greeting. Generally, if you know him, there is no problem. But if you want to write very formally, dear colleague, dear Ahmad, if you know some more, hello Ahmad. Of course, the European peoples are using hello. Good morning or good afternoon, your name. I don't advise you people to use the less formal. Hi. Hi, Muhammad. Hey, these are the nowadays I found in professionally also they are using it, but not advisable to it. Body. After the greeting, heading, greeting, subject line, body. Body should be reactive, your subject. Your subject is something, the body of the mail is something, then it will be not good for it. Your subject body should react. What you want to sell subject, that only in the body. If it is having a big thing to explain, then make into paragraphs. But make very clear and specific and concise. And direct method of, don't use the indirect method. Use the direct method of construct. Whatever the you are constructing a mail, directly you say that. Main point, the management wants to discuss so and so thing. The management is planning to discuss. It's indirect. So give them very direct main points. And closing also give the summary, basing on all above. It is essential that your opinion is good in polite way, in a very, very polite way. The indirect method, it is not advisable, my friend. But anyhow, sometimes if you don't want to fix into the problem, your manager says, give warning. Then you will give warning in indirect method. It was observed by the management that you are coming late, and which is against to the policy of the company. So we request you to change your attendance behavior so that you will not face any consequences. Then that fellow will not come and ask you, have you seen I am coming late? No, because you mentioned that the management, I don't know who is that management. If he is doing correctly, then he keep quiet, they will try to change his attitude. If he not correct, then he informs you that, no, I am coming regularly. Then you will inform the management he is coming regularly. So that is the way what we can say that whenever you don't want to be fixed, you can use, but it is not at all. And I don't know whether this video I am giving you, you can take it. This video is one of the video which is a very important one to give us etiquettes, whether you will get the time is there, but I don't know whether you will get the sound from this video. Let me check. If not, after that you can take it. It is really a good video. Are you able to listen voice of the video? Hello?
No, doctor, we are unable to see the video.
You are unable to see the video?
No.
What happened to
one minute? Can you click again to share? Click again to share and okay. While sharing, oh. There's an yes. Option there, include computer sound.
Okay, okay, inshallah. Yeah. One minute, I will share once again. Here, the entire screen, madam, or Windows? What I should do? Chrome tab.
Select window.
Window.
But, yeah, but enable that option, including computer sound. It is there while sharing. Click on share. There is an option there.
So I should keep beating Microsoft. I should clear.
What?
Share. If share has come, are you able to see now? Are you able to see the my now? You're able to yeah. See?
For me, still. Yeah. Now it is okay. But okay. Open the video now.
Yes, video is open, madam, already.
It's open the video. It's coming like Google and YouTube.
You see?
And there is no sound also.
Sound also not there. This one video, are you unable to see the video, madam?
No, not yet for me.
Okay. You see here. No. Windows, I kept documents. This is showing. Microsoft Teams, this is only coming.
Yeah, but once you click on share, there's an option there. Before you click screen,
are you able to see? Option. Are you able to see, madam, now?
For me, still, it is not coming.
Are you able to see?
Yes, it is there.
Hey.
But there is no sound.
Oh, so sorry then. I will share this link to you in chat.
Yeah, better.
So you people can take this one. I will link this link. I will be sharing whenever time, anytime you can check it. Thank you. Sorry to the problem. I will share this link to you people in the chat. Okay. So I gave this one. Okay. Now, anyhow, this is the last point. We are coming very near to it. What should we do and what should not do to improve our email communication? What are the things we have to do? What are the things we should not do? So in this one, what are the things? Do. First, from the beginning, I am telling, keep your email short, effective, and should not more than few lines. Your email should be in only few lines. Don't reply to all until it is necessary. To say thanks is sometimes what happened, someone will give mail, thank you, they will reply to all. Don't do such things. Don't reply to all. If it is necessary, then only do it. And don't copy the entire universe. Copying more people won't get you message read more. Sometimes what happened, something you want to say, you will give full stop. Stop at the rate of nct.edu. Maybe they are not interested. If you continuously giving like that mails, after sometimes what happened, they never open your email. They think that this is not related, always this person will be sending mail to us. So they will be thinking that it is common, always same like that only, sending mails to us. So don't knock twice. Once you say, After sending the mail, some people say that I just send you a mail. Already you sent. Why unnecessarily to knock him? Don't use the silly fonts. Sometimes they'll use the different fonts and colors. You are not decorating. It is a mail. Color fonts are just as bad. Keep it simple. Very simple. And don't use humor. Of course, humor is alive. But don't use humor in your professional mails. And don't assume the recipient knows what you are talking. Don't keep something hidden and write something. You think that already he knows. Whether he knows or not, we don't know. And punctuation, just now I used thanks, exclamatory. Like that, punctuations should be very carefully. To improve the some backward, if you give something, you are giving answer to him, just give the same thread, maintain the same thread, so that the person will be understand that in which thing you are telling. Try to stop the culture of remind. In some organization, this is the biggest mistake of that. They give the mail, they say that due by 30th. Next day will send one reminder on 26, 27, 28. Why reminder? No need. Qualitatively, it is very wrong. Avoid giving remind. His duty, he has to do. If he's not doing, then it's wrong. Avoid command, egoistic. In your, you should answer, you should. You must do this. No, don't use that one. Be polite. Be polite. And some of the reference we are giving on YouTube. In YouTube, if you go, my friend, if you develop the good habits of etiquette of the professional mail, really, I'm telling you, you will be respected in your organization, and other people will remind you that, oh, in your organization, someone is there. His mails are very good. So these are the few things which I try to share with you myself. If you have any suggestions, any things, up to now I was talking. Now my role become to be your role, a listening. Anything you want to tell, my friends? Hello? Anything you want to tell? You are welcome. No, don't feel shy that, or if you want to tell in Arabic, no problem. You can tell, Ms. Zubaina is there. Some other people also there, they may give. Hello? Hello? Are you able to listen? Hello? Zubaina madam? Zubaina madam? Hello? Hello? Yeah, listen. Okay, thank you. My mic is unmuted only. For all, okay.
Yes, doctor.
Can you unmute, madam, for all attendees?
Okay, I will unmute. Just wait.
If anyone wants to say something, they can tell.
Okay. Okay, now the mic is enabled. Those who have any question, they can open the mic.
MashaAllah, the organizers have worked a lot. 47 attendees, 49 attendees are come. I hope that you may ask anything, so I will develop my presentation in future also. I am thankful to Zubaina madam and others who have helped me a lot.
Yeah.
Anything you want to ask?
Anyone have a question?
Anyone, please, you can give suggestion to me, not a question only. No.
Okay, if there is no question, so let's conclude, doctor, or
yes,
you have something else?
No, ma'am, we can conclude.
Okay.
Inshallah, I request the organizer to just share the feedback also so that it will be helpful to me.
Inshallah.
Thank you. Consolidated feedback. Thank you, madam.
Thank you so much, Dr. Shafi' al-Din, for these workshops and for your informative information.
Thank you.
I hope that all attendees understanding and get benefits also from this. And see you, inshallah, in the future workshop, inshallah. الحضور هل استلمتوا رابط الفيدباك؟ رابط التقييم اوريدي انا حطيته في الشير هنا في الشات. راح اعيد مره ثانيه. يس دكتور.
اوكي ثانك يو.
هذا هو رابط الفيدباك. طبعا نفس الشيء ارسلت قبل شويه اللي هو رابط القناه على اليوتيوب. رابط القناة على اليوتيوب قناة الكلية اللي حاب يتابع الورش السابقة اللي قدمناها خلال هذا الملتقى أو هذه الورشة مرة ثانية نفس الشيء كلها بتكون موجودة على القناة بإذن الله. رابط الفيدباك أرفقته. أتمنى أنكم تدرجوا أسماءكم باللغة العربية صحيحة كامل. الإيميلات تتأكدوا أنها صحيحة علشان نرسلكم الشهادات لاحقا. إرسال شهادات راح يوصلكم إن شاء الله فيها إيميل احتمال على الأسبوع المقبل إن شاء الله. وشكرا جزيلا لكم على الحضور ونلتقي بكم إن شاء الله في ورش قادمة بإذن الله. أيوة أخت نادية، ممكن بإمكانك مرة ثانية تسجلي وترخلي الاسم باللغة العربية يفضل.